Good afternoon, this is Joseph Bradley from Amon Ross. I'm one of the voices of Amon Ross. And I have a message here from Jesus Christ. And please, the messages that I have are in a journey form. So, in order to truly understand the message, you have to listen to the video from beginning to end. Close your eyes and listen to the sound of my voice and journey with me with the message that Jesus has to offer us today. I spin to an area. There's a sun in front of me. A sun in the middle of the universe. I am hovering above the sun, looking down at it. Jesus has my hand and he is beside me. He smiles at me. What do you see, Joseph? I see the sun, the golden light, the explosions, the fire. What else do you see? I look more intensely at the sun. I see the light in the center. Yes, Joseph. What about the light in the center? It is bluish white and is very, very intense. And all of a sudden we're standing in the core of the sun. Every time I wave my hand and move, it streaks. What ask if I tell you to take a hold of the core? Then I would take a hold of it. So please, take the core and place it in your hands. I walk up to the core and I hold it. It isn't much bigger than a globe, but when I touch it, it sends energy to every part of my body, blowing away any physical aspects of myself, revealing flames of bluish white light. It is so intense. Now place it in your heart, Joseph. So I place it in my heart. I spin really quickly and explode. Explosion shatters the sun and goes out and out towards so fast in every direction. We are on the tip of one of the explosions now, going through the universe. As explosion hits smaller planets, they just turn to dust. Explosion. Destruction. But then, every time a planet gets destroyed, its light connects onto the explosion and goes with us. So, Joseph, nothing truly dies, does it? The physical, like your physical body, is no longer. We are spirits traveling the universe on the wake of an explosion. destroying? Or is it destroying, or is it giving life again? See, Joseph, as things fall apart, new stuff is reborn. When something is destroyed, when something dies, it is not dead. It is reborn into the light. It is that simple. So everyone who is listening, I do not understand why you do not understand this one simple thing. There is many that do, but there are so many that do not understand that nothing truly dies. It is reborn into light. So we continue to ride. The explosion wanes just before the planet. The planet is full of life. Instead, the explosion is weak. It hits the Earth. Well, I guess you could call it Earth. It is not Earth, but it is a planet full of life. And all of a sudden, northern lights explode all around the poles. It is so beautiful. The colors that once were bluish white light transform into the most intense purples and greens and reds I've ever seen. Northern lights, nothing like I've seen before. We're on the planet's surface now, looking up. The sky is exploding with the most beautiful northern lights I've ever seen. Even animals stop to look up. They are in awe of the beauty of it. Nothing is hurt. No one dies. Just the beauty of life. If this planet was any closer, it would have been destroyed like all the rest. But it wasn't its time yet. This time was not here. Time of destruction. People say God does not save the world. Well, in time, all things must die, but only when they are meant to. If God wanted this planet to be destroyed at this moment in time, it would have been placed farther away, like all the other planets that were destroyed. This one was not meant to die yet. And again, nothing truly dies, it is transformed. But instead, everybody and everything that lives on this planet is gifted with some of the most beautiful auroras this world has ever seen. And it will last for days, Joseph, weeks. They will be blessed with the most beautiful memories that they will live their lives out, never seeing such a beautiful display of auroras ever again. So this was the gift to this world, to the animals and the people at this time. They were gifted the beauty of love and light. Nothing on this planet would truly understand how close they came to die. Would it really make a difference if I spoke to them and said that the lights you have seen almost destroyed your planet? Would that serve any purpose? The beauty that God created for this world would be tarnished. The meaning behind the words would destroy the beauty that the gift they were given. See, Joseph, when we speak to each other, we have to be so careful on what we say to one another. Sometimes things should not be said. If a child is smiling and happy, it does something wrong. Should we crush their heart in that moment, or should we wait to the right moment to speak? The right moment to say the words at the right time. So often we say words that hurt. We say words that cut deep. But we do not need to. The words should be unspoken, because they serve no purpose except to hurt each other. So why would we speak those words? Why would we speak words just to hurt one another? So the next time you speak words that you know will hurt and serve no purpose, do not speak them. Instead, speak words of love and understanding. And sometimes just let the children play. Let them play. Let them learn. Do not control everything they do. How would they ever learn if we did everything for them? The children of every world is their future. So why would we not let them learn? Let them grow. Let them experience the beauty of life. The beauty of life. Our children teach us so many things, but we choose not to listen. They play. They laugh. They cry. It is very genuine. Because their emotions have not been stifled by the world we live in. Come, there's something else I wish to show you. We're standing over the world. This time it is Earth. And there's wars everywhere. We land in the middle of a war. What is this purpose? What does this serve the world? We kill, we maim, in the name of what? People kill one another because they believe they are right. Some kill for pleasure. Some kill for a little bit of both. But war is war. If I kill my brothers because I believe I am right, then my brothers will kill other brothers because they believe they are right. So every time we kill, our brothers will kill as well. Will it ever end? It will never end, because every time we kill one another, it creates a new cycle. Every time we glorify death and war, we create a situation to provoke more death and war. The cycle will never stop until we stop killing each other. I placed my heart on the ground in this place. The love goes into everyone and everything. It's the only way, Joseph. The only way to stop war, stop hate, to truly understand what love is, what death is, what life is to love one another, to help one another. It is simple as that. It is that simple. And like you're told before, Joseph, that love will spread to every corner of the world. But people must choose it. People must live it. There is so many excuses. There's so many reasons why, they say, not to love each other. But love is the only way we can be free, all of us, from the chaos. That was a message from Jesus. I am the voice of Amun-Ras. Thank you very much. You can visit my website at www.amunras.com.